kanina, as of the presentation, it's close to 250,000 family food packs just for this region. Admittedly, Mr. President, it's one of the larger releases natin, but we have more in the warehouse and more is coming in. And based on your instructions, now we'll keep on sustaining it. So we, one way or another, we've communicated to the governors, the congressional representations, the mayors, that they can lodge the request at regional office. We still have stocks and we'll continue doing so. Mr. President, also, I'd like to mention that over the weekend, tama si Sec Gibo, the Air Force and the Navy have been moving our goods from one point to another. In fact, doon sa kina Kong Chino and General Generoso, it was the Navy that brought the family food packs. And then doon gov sa couple of towns in Caraga, it was airlifted by the choppers ng Black Hawks ng Air Force. And they'll continue doing so. We still have the goods, so we'll continue moving that, Mr. President. Number two, Mr. President, the mention of the emergency cash transfer,
yes,
which we've also instructed na people will have to move from food to cash. So as mentioned, the Davao del Norte group has already submitted their list. We initiated the payout yesterday. But may dagdag pala. So we'll just wait for the listing ulit. I think the provincial government and si Kong Duhali has been very active in scouring the area and giving us the list. We've already made representation and spoken to the congressional representatives, the governors, about the other provinces na sana mabigay na yung list so we can start doing the payout. So we can transition from food to cash, kasi you always say nga na, Mr. President, na hindi lahat ng kailangan nila matatagpuan doon sa kahon. Based on our discussions, they really need the cash because nga, some of them may not have been affected physically yung bahay, but yung livelihood, hindi nakapag-ngisda, hindi nakapag-saka. So, I think we've already squared off with almost everybody in the table privately, one way or another, over the week na if they can send the list over, we can immediately download the cash sa regional office namin and initiate the payouts. We're also adding more special disbursing officers para simultaneous sa iba-ibang mga probinsya. And last, Mr. President, the next slide, the more important slide that I've been tasked to read, yung sa Office of the Presidential Assistance.
Yes.
Mr. President, I was tasked by your office to go through this list. So for the information of the governors and the affected LGUs, on top of the emergency cash transfer, hiwalay huto, our president has authorized the release from his presidential social fund a total amount of 265 million. And the breakdown are as follows. The province of Davao del Norte will get 30 million. The province of Davao Oriental will get 30 million. The province of Agusan del Sur will get 30 million. The province of Davao de Oro will get 30 million. The province of Surigao del Sur will get 25 million. The province of Maguindanao del Sur, 25 million. Davao City, 20 million. Butuan City, 20 million. Province of Davao Occidental, 20 million. The province of Agusan del Norte, 15 million. The province of Cotabato, 10 million. And the province of Bukidnon, 10 million, to sum up 265 million. So for the information of the governors, the president has authorized the immediate release of the presidential assistance from his presidential social civic fund on top of the emergency cash assistance that he has also authorized. So the president has instructed us to mobilize food and cash immediately. Yes. Thank you, Mr. President.
I think we, from the reports that we have had, I think that we are doing all right in the food, but the provision of food packs, etc. But as the secretary was explaining, that it gets to the point na hindi na pagkain, hindi lang pagkain ang kailangan ng tao, that they need to buy other things na para sa kanilang household, no? So that's why the ECTs have become very important, and that's why I released the 265 million to make sure that phase of the response is immediate. At maramdaman kaagad ng tao, mayroon kaagad silang tulong, maramdaman nila kaagad kung ano yung kailangan nila. Yeah, meron silang gagamitin sa pangangailangan nila. The other thing I wanted to ask about is there was only one report about the problem on water supply. What are we doing in terms of providing? Usually, kumukuha tayo sa
gamot, kumukuha tayo ng mga purifiers and
yes,
the pro, ano,
nasa, ah, sir, sir, tinawag ko na and tomorrow darating na po sila.
Oh,
I'm just looking at the team.
Siyempre, that's very important kasi kung hindi magandang tubig, hindi sapat yung tubig.
Yes, sir.
People will start drinking from questionable sources, magkasakit pa, we will have an outbreak of all kinds of things.
Sir, ang dadalhin po, hindi tankers, mga portable po na naka-backpack lang.
Yung bago, so, maliit na eh. Yeah. Pwede na kailangan ni, ano, pwedeng dalhin kahit saan.
Yes, sir.
Para mag, dahil it's okay, we will bring as much water as we can, but hindi pwedeng, yun na lang, we cannot keep bringing water, we have to provide a water supply. That is sufficient without bringing in bottled water. So our solution to that has always been to bring water purifiers, some kind of water purifier. Dati, truck-truck pa yan. Ngayon, the technologies have improved. Pwede nang dalhin ng tao. So because I didn't see very much response in terms of the water. But that's as critical as anything else. Especially at this point, because you cannot do anything without clean water.
And Mr. President, they are all solar powered.
How many can we?
We could immediately mobilize at least 80 teams, and we're actually asking for more from MMDA.
Oh,
so I will just coordinate with the SecCubo for the transportation tomorrow.
Just bring young, especially the more isolated areas.
Sir.
Hindi ba? Yeah. Hindi naaabot ng mga bottled water na pinapadala natin. Those are the priority areas. So anyway, from the general reports that we are getting, I think that we are all right in terms of relief. Pero meron na naman tayong nag-landslide. So we have to go back again to rescue, search and rescue. Pero anyway, for the most part, we're na medyo maayos naman na sufficient naman ang binibigay na relief goods in terms of ano, and the other things such as the sanitation kits, all the other non-food items that are also being brought by DSWD. So magsata ba just continue to inform us as to what is needed. Dahil yung mga numero natin ngayon, hindi na yan, tumaas na yan eh. Dumami na yan eh. As you can see from the changes that we have seen from the shear line to the LPA, there are changes now. Tapos the event is still ongoing in some areas. So we'll have to watch that. The infrastructure problem, really, we will have to we will prioritize the thoroughfares, the roads that are necessary for us to be able to bring whatever relief goods are necessary, all of these water purifiers, etc., the equipment that's necessary, make sure that every barangay maabot natin. Yung mga isolated, yun ang unahin natin. Maghanap tayo ng paraan na makadaan yung mga sasakyan natin para maidala yung mga pangangailangan. Like again, the food and non-food items of the DSWD. Yung helicopter is okay, pero kukunti lang ang kanilang kayang dalhin. We need truck ang kailangan dyan eh.
Yes, sir. Truck at saka tao-tao plus helicopters. But, sir, I've asked General Bronner also to reach out to his counterparts. Maybe there may be an opportunity for a mutual combined operation here.
All right.
Likewise, Mr. President, I also requested General Bronner because we've noticed that we have meals ready to eat. Our troops in the field really don't eat because they like hot meals, and these are perfect for evacuation centers because they're already MREs. They're about to expire, some of them, so maybe we can swap with the DSWD for rice and canned goods which our troops really use rather than the MREs.
Oh, para i-recycle na natin.
And the MREs, sir, are very convenient because they're already individual food packs for 3 meals a day.
Relief goods, etc., I think are okay. Water supply, we're going to attend to. And make sure that we'll continue to bring in bottled water as much as we can. But it gets to a point na hindi talaga kaya na dahil ang bigat-bigat eh. At saka ang laki ng dinadala, is much easier, much better to have the purifier. So that's what we will bring to those areas that that need it. On the infrastructure side, we will prioritize those roads and thoroughfares that are necessary for us to be able to provide support to those who have become victims. So yun ang unahin natin. On the longer term, we really have to start design, looking at the designs of these bridges and roads to see kung if they are still the designs are still compatible with the weather patterns and the effects that DNR is going to provide us with the guidance in terms of how we proceed, because we cannot basta't kung i-rebuild lang natin lahat ng nasira, ganun din ang mangyayari. That's the same thing will happen. Or if we're going to rebuild it, we have to rebuild it maybe in a way that is more kailangan mas matibay, kailangan it's stronger, etc., all of that. So that's something that I think that we can attend to as quickly as possible. But again, the situation is still changing. In terms of the cash transfers, that one is immediate. So it's now up to the LGUs to provide us with the listing, etc. But we will already release this. Kayo nang bahala kung saan yung dadalhin. Because of course you have you know kung sinong nangangailangan more than anybody else. Ano pang kailangan ninyo?
Mr. President, just to add, kausap ko na po yung MMDA. They'll be tomorrow, they'll be having here 80 machines which will give about 180 gallons per hour ang isang makina po. So madami po ito dire-diretso.
Yes, sir. Very practical yung mga yung water
180 gallons per hour. One
kahit,
machine.
Kahit saan kumuha machine ng tubig, pwede. Paglabas, yes, malinis talaga.
Tomorrow deliver na po ng MMDA.
Oh, sige. All right. Yes, go.
One more request po for the DSWD. Kasi nga, because of the landslide that we had last night, there are many that we evacuated in several evacuation centers. So we need ASAP po sana mga additional tents po.
Yes, ma'am.
Tents po.
Tent shelters.
Shelters. Kasi andun lang sila sa mga GM, yung iba, tapos walang...
Baka ilan ng...
Kasi 800 families. Oo. Kasi tatlong barangays po yung evacuate naman.
Sige, Gov. We'll mobilize it. Meron po kami. Kakadating din lang.
Okay. Right. Thank you.
We have to hear from you, from the local government, kasi kayo talagang nakakaalam. The national government is only here to support you.
Tanong ko po, Mr. President, ito lang po gusto ko lang i-clear. Kung during the distribution of the pod packs or any support coming from the national government or the coming from the Department of Social Welfare and Development or the DOLI, sino po ba ang authorized to distribute? Is the local government ba, like municipio, the city, the province, or
depending on what the assistance is to the
any elected official po?
Yes, go ahead.
Like in the food packs kasi, iba-iba yung request na natatanggap namin. And we try to fulfill ng sabay-sabay. There will be requests from the provincial level, we'll give it to the province. There will be requests direct from the mayors, we give it to the mayors.
Yes.
There will be requests from the congress people, we'll give it to the congress people. So at this point in time, I would assume dahil lahat tayo busy,
yes,
the different elected officials are all tasked to move all at the same time. So yun.
Usually, ganun ang sistema.
Yes po.
Sa local government talaga binababa. Meron like yung sa Dole, sa bawat isa, silang nag-assess it. Silang gumagawa ng assessment. But for the most part, it's really local government. Kasi sinasagot lang namin yung request ninyo.
Yes po, Mr. President. Kasi during calamity, ang kumukuha ng data at ang gumagawa ng quick response is the municipio, the city, and the province. And also collecting data, kami ang lahat ng in-charge, yung LGU at PLGU. But like what happened in Davao del Norte, minsan kasi may hindi po nakarating sa province. Pero na-distribute, iba naman ang nag-distribute. And gusto po ako mag-thank you po kay Ma'am Inday Sara na quick response po, nagbigay kagad siya ng support doon sa Davao del Norte po. Ma'am. Thank you so much po, Ma'am.
Antonio, you had wanted to add something.
Lahat naman na nag-request, doon naman yung bibigay. Pag hindi mag-request, hindi na bibigay. Tapos, pag nawawala dito, hindi rin nabibigay sa inyo. Kung wala kayo, we have to go to the next who's there, di ba? So, yun yung mga nangyayari.
Pero mostly, LGU talaga.
Yeah.
LGU talaga ang inaasahan namin. Oh. We depend on the... We cannot... The national government cannot do this by itself. As I said, we support you with cash transfer, with relief goods. But kayo ang magsasabi sa amin kung saan dadalhin, kung saan ang uunahin, saan yung hindi na nga pwedeng pumasok, etc., etc. Yes, LGU pa rin, LGU. LGU-centric ang national government. All right, is there anything else that anybody would like to add? All right, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. At this point, the President shall lead the turnover of assistance from the Office of the President to the affected cities and municipalities in the region. May we call on Governor Dorothy Gonzaga, together with the mayors of Davao de Oro, to receive the check. At this point, we call on Governor Gonzaga together with the mayors of Davao de Oro to receive the check. Now may we call on Governor Edwin Hubahib together with the mayors of Davao del Norte to receive the check. Next, Governor Nino Soteruy, together with the mayors of Davao Oriental, to receive the check. Davao Occidental Provincial Administrator Attorney Geoffrey Navarra, together with the provincial treasurer, to receive the check. Please prepare Davao City Operations and Warning Division Acting Head, Mr. Rodrigo Bustillo, to receive the check. Cue, Mr. President. This assistance will surely benefit the people of Davao Region.